Good morning. I've been noticing a lot of uncertainty, anxiety, and fear over the coronavirus outbreak, and I just wanted to take a few moments to go over some statistics that I looked up online that I think will help calm your fears and put things into perspective. Now, I'm by no means downplaying the seriousness of the situation, nor am I saying you shouldn't use sensible precautions like social distancing, nor am I downplaying the loss of those who have lost loved ones to this virus. I just simply want to put things into perspective. According to Johns Hopkins University, an estimated 721,000 people worldwide have been infected with the coronavirus. Out of the estimated 721,000 infected, 33,000 people worldwide have died from the infection. According to the CDC, the number of coronavirus cases here in the United States have passed 142,000. Out of the 142,000 cases, 2,500 people have died from the infection. To put this in perspective, this is out of an estimated worldwide population of over 7 billion people, or an estimated population of 327.2 million people here in the United States. Let's put this further into perspective. According to the World Health Organization, 17.9 people die each year from heart disease or cardiovascular disease. The CDC reports that an estimated 647,000 Americans die from heart disease or cardiovascular disease each year. That equals one in every four deaths. That's an alarming rate. The World Health Organization also reports that 9.6 million people die from cancer every year, while the American Cancer Society reports that 606,520 Americans died in 2018 from cancer. The CDC also states that 1.3 million people die in car accidents every year worldwide. That's 3,700 people a day who die in motor vehicle-related accidents. The CDC stated that an estimated 32,000 Americans are killed every year in vehicle accidents. That's an estimated 90 Americans killed every day from motor vehicle-related accidents. Lastly, the World Health Organization reports an estimated 646,000 people die each year from falls. This is the second leading cause of death worldwide, heart disease and stroke being the number one cause of death worldwide. The CDC reports an estimated 30,000 Americans die each year from falls. What am I trying to say? People die every day from diseases, car accidents, and cancer, some of which are far more horrible than coronavirus will ever be. Now, I'm not trying, like I said earlier, I'm not trying to downplay the loss of those who lost loved ones. I know of all people how hard it is to lose a loved one to disease. I lost my mom to lung cancer. I watched her go back for 2 months and pass away from it. It traveled to her brain. She couldn't even walk. It was hard to watch. It was hard to see. And seeing her die was hard. And I lost my grandma to Alzheimer's disease. Just watching her go back over 2 years and then boom. It was very hard, very difficult. I'm by no means trying to downplay the sense of loss people feel or the seriousness of the situation. Just saying that death is part of life. I'm not trying to be heartless in saying that, but it is. It is a part of life. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 says, "To everything there is a time and season, a time for every purpose under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to gain and a time to lose, a time to keep silence and a time to speak. And that's true. There is a time and season for everything. And again, I'm not trying to be heartless. Loss is hard, and I am truly sorry. And you have my condolences. I know it sounds trite, but that's all I can offer to each and every one of you who have lost loved ones to this disease. And I want to send my condolences to everyone who lost loved ones to heart disease, to cancer, to car accidents, plane accidents. Everyone is losing someone every day, and my heart goes out to each and every one of you. And if I had the time and lifespan, I'd give each and every one of you a hug and tell you it's going to be okay. Again, I know it sounds trite. I just wanted to put things in perspective. Yes, coronavirus is scary. I get that. And a lot of you young adults in your 20s, this is probably the scariest thing that's ever happened to you as far as disease is concerned. You haven't lived as long as the rest of us have. And yes, in a large way, this is the most progressive of measures that any of us have seen for a very long time. Now, my dad and my mom would probably say they did a similar reaction during the Cuban Missile Crisis where everybody was on their toes. Those of us old enough remember 9/11 and how scary that was and the uncertainty of those times. And why am I bringing these up? To remind you that we got through them. We will get through this. I know it seems scary now. Uncertainty is always scary. But if you could put a little perspective of things and everything that this country and the world has been through, if you study American history, world history, whatever, both preferably, you'll see that we have been through far worse things than this and far more deadly things than this. We went through cholera, tuberculosis, typhoid, yellow fever, scarlet fever, smallpox. We got through them all. We will get through this. The human race will survive. The human race will continue until the appointed time where God ends all things. So we don't need to panic and get scared and run around hoarding things because of the uncertain times. We can step back and realize there are worse things in this life than the coronavirus. In fact, we read in the statistics how many more people die from heart disease every day, how many more people die from cancer every day, how many people die from just being hit by a car or being in a car accident every day. You are more likely to get hit by a car and die than you are to get this virus. You are more statistically likely to fall down your steps and die than you are to get of getting this virus and dying. Most people, according to the CDC and the World Health Organization, have said, unless you have a severely compromised immune system, diabetes, some form of cancer, asthma, or you're on some kind of cancer treatment or immunosuppressive therapy, you are going to be fine if you get this disease. You're more than likely going to get flu-like symptoms, recover, and be fine. If you have any of the above conditions or you are in immunosuppressive therapy, yes, you should use extra precautions. Stay home. If you have loved ones at home with these conditions, you should stay home and make sure you do your best that they don't get it. But remember, there are other ways that you're more likely going to die than these diseases. And yet again, I'm not trying to be morbid. I'm just trying to put things into perspective. You've seen how many people die in car accidents. We don't outlaw cars and ban them. We just learn to use common sense. When you're walking across the street, look both ways so you don't walk out in front of traffic and get hit. When you're driving your car, you wear your seatbelt because that way you won't fly out of your vehicle. Common sense approaches. More, you saw that falls are the second leading cause of death. You use common sense. You don't walk down the stairs with both your hands full. You use the banister. You watch your feet when you're walking up and down steps. You do as much as you can to avoid death. I get that. Nobody wants to die. I don't want to die. No, I'm not afraid to die, but I'm not in a hurry to get there. But worrying about how you might die, or worry about dying from the coronavirus, or getting hit by a car, or whatever it is just makes no sense. All it's going to do is rob you of the joy of life. All it's going to do is rob you of the peace that God wants you to have. God wants you to live life with peace and joy and happiness. He doesn't want you constantly fearing death and constantly being afraid of what might happen. Of course, use common sense precautions. Follow the social distancing guidelines. If you have a compromised immune system, wear a mask when you have to go out for groceries. Then go out, get your groceries, come home. If you're healthy and you don't have a compromised immune system, you're not on immunosuppressive therapy, then you still can go out for a walk. Go for a walk around your property. Go for a walk around the block. Just use social distancing. And just like with the flu or anything else, if you see somebody's hacking and sneezing, don't walk up and give them a big old hug. I know it might be hard not to hug, but it says in Ecclesiastes there's a time to embrace and there's a time to refrain from embracing. So refrain from embracing until this passes. But don't live your life in fear. Don't be caught up in the sensationalism. Look up the facts and figures for yourself. And realize the amount of people dying from this disease versus the amount of people being infected by it is minuscule. Again, I'm not downplaying the loss to those who lost loved ones to this disease. I'm simply saying perspective. Realize that death is part of life. And when it's your time, it's your time. But it also says in God's word, many places, that you can actually die before your time simply by worrying. Because when you worry so much about something happen, you can actually cause it to happen. You can actually convince yourself you're sick without actually being sick. And you can actually talk yourself to death, literally. You could talk yourself into dying from something you don't even have simply because you're so afraid that you might have it, that your body acts like it does have it even if it doesn't have it, or can actually make you more susceptible to getting it because worry lowers your immune system. So again, I don't want to beat you over the head. I don't want to sound heartless. Just use sensible precautions. Use common sense and wisdom and you'll be okay. But stop perpetuating panic and fear and spreading misinformation. This isn't the apocalypse. It's not the end of the world. It is not the disease that's going to kill off a third or more of mankind. It is, in the grand scheme of things, a nuisance disease. We get nuisance diseases that reach these proportions every decade or so. It's happened before. It'll happen again. We've gotten through it before. We'll get through it now, and we'll get through it then. We as Americans, we as human beings across the world, wherever you come from, are strong, resilient people. Human beings are a strong, resilient race. We will survive. We will not only survive, we will thrive. Will it be difficult times ahead as we restart our economies and get things going again? Yes. But again, we got through a Great Depression once. If it happens, which I don't believe it will, we'll get through it again. Why? Because human beings are a hardy race. And as we say here in America, we have a can-do, will-not-give-up attitude. We survived 9/11, my fellow Americans. Not to keep bringing up that tragedy. Sorry for everyone that lost loved ones in that too. I still remember where I was that day. We will survive this just like we survived that. No one can keep an American down. No one can keep a Canadian down. No one can keep a European down. Wherever you're from, no one can keep you down. The only one that can keep you down is yourself. Because you can talk yourself out of life by fear. Or you can talk life into yourself by being bold, using wisdom and common sense, and trusting that this will pass, because it will pass. Thank you for your time. Remember, be at peace. This will pass. You have a blessed day.